this is Eric.
Hey, Eric, how's it going?
Hey there, Michelle. Pretty good. How you doing?
Oh, pretty good. I had a question for you. Something came up in our community garden plot that started me thinking about the organic regulations, and I thought you'd be the guy to talk to.
Huh, that's interesting. So what is it?
Well, it's an issue with poison ivy.
Poison ivy? You guys are growing poison ivy in your vegetable garden? Come on.
Well, we are growing it, but not on purpose.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure, because, you know, we're always trying to figure out what the next crop is here in California, and I figured maybe we're missing out on something.
Yeah, we are pretty progressive out here, but not that advanced.
Okay. So what was the question?
Well, we have the poison ivy. It's growing in our fence line, and my wife, Martha, she's super sensitive to poison ivy, and she's pulled it out one too many times and been on steroids one too many times, so she said, enough of that. I'm going to use this new product, new to her at least. It's called Roundup. You ever heard of it?
Of course I know what Roundup is. You know, in fact, you know, maybe I shouldn't admit this, but I've actually used a little bit of Roundup at my house to deal with some pretty nasty weeds.
Say what? You're Mr. Organic. You're not supposed to use that stuff.
Hey, you know, just because I do organic research for a living, that doesn't mean that I can't use some of this stuff at home. You know, sometimes just a little bit of it in a special situation might kind of help. Anyway, so what's the issue with Roundup?
So we used it. It did a great job. It got rid of the poison ivy. But unfortunately, some of our neighbors who garden organically and consider us some of the hardcore organic gardeners, once they're using Roundup, must have challenged their worldview or something, and they went to the city. Our gardens are on city property. And they asked them to require everyone to use only organic certified methods in the garden plots.
That seems a little bit extreme to me.
Martha and I thought so. Anyway, after 2 years of going in front of city council for hearings and explaining what was going on, they finally realized that we were not trying to ruin the planet, that we were just trying to control a little bit of poison ivy with some targeted use of Roundup. So in the end, they did not pass any new regulations about everybody having to be organic. Anyway, the whole process got me thinking more about the organic regulations and how certified organic farmers address challenging problems. And it got me to thinking that sometimes the regulations can actually lead to some less than sustainable practices, I thought.
Interesting. So like, what do you mean?
Well, what if a farmer has a major issue with perennial weeds that could be hard to deal with using organically approved methods, but could be dealt with relatively easily with a systemic herbicide when the problem first appears, and it wouldn't require a lot of that systemic herbicide? It could be applied in targeted fashion.
Interesting. You know, you actually kind of hit the nail right in the head with that one, because in our long-term research, we're actually starting to get some field bindweed showing up in one of our research plots. And I'll tell you what, field bindweed scares the heck out of me, because that thing can spread. And what I'm worried about is that the only way that we're going to be able to control this is probably with a lot of tillage. And I've kind of wondered if we could just use a little bit of a systemic herbicide like glyphosate or Roundup, maybe we could actually eliminate it really early on before it gets out of hand. Well, and actually from a soil health perspective, less tillage might actually be better for the soil health than, you know, using a lot of tillage to get rid of a perennial weed.
Yeah, that's kind of what I'm getting at. I wonder if there should be some way for an organic farmer to apply for some kind of waiver or an allowance to deal with some specific kinds of problems. And I think this perennial weed problem might be a good example of this. If you think of it kind of like cancer, if you deal with it when it's small and it hasn't spread, you could deal with it quickly and it doesn't get out of hand.
That could actually be pretty effective, especially if it didn't lead to people over-relying on some of these inputs. You know, just using them in a real worst-case scenario.
I think it's something to think about. I think one of the issues with the organic regulations is that having one rule to address all different systems, to deal with all different crops with the same rules, that might not be scientifically valid.
That's a good point. You know, we could actually talk about this at this conference that's coming up in Phoenix.
Yeah, we should talk about it there, see what people think.
Yeah, because you know what? The only way that we're ever going to improve these organic systems is if we share our concerns. You know, talk about some of our ideas that some people might think are a little bit crazy. And if people have an opportunity to not be afraid to bring up ideas that might be a little bit out there.
Okay, let's do it.
Hey, sounds good, man. I'll see you there in Phoenix.